Hello everybody, this is my new flea market found. I didn't make any videos last month because I was sick. I was pneumonia. And right now I feel okay. But I don't get this virus. Okay, this is Panasonic DVD A350, and this is professional DVD CD player class AA. You can see here normal buttons, open, close, skip, play, charge button, and phone level. This is extra simple. And behind, SCART of course, power connection, S video out composite 1 and 2, mixed audio. This is TV, I believe. Connect TV here, eat audio out front, use it for AV receiver or other. Okay. And here is normal stereo output. Surround, left, right, and subwoofer, center speaker, coaxial and optical. Very good. This look very dirty. So I believe I need to open this machine, clean outside, and lubricate this machine, because this is an old machine and not used several months or even years. So I need to check that in first, because if this motor gears and everything is dry, it's kind of broken when I put power on. So better to look and how you say it. Okay, and big question is how much I paid for it. 12 euros only, I would say. This is an old machine, but this is quality machine, and I don't have a very good quality CD player. I have normal CD players, and then I have Blu-ray, but I don't know it. Blu-ray is so high quality CD player. Okay. Full of stuff. Okay, this look nice. No capacitors, no leaking signs. Looking good. This is nice. Only 4 screws. Okay, and I have here extra CD. Sony Music, Anne Mattila, Kuivaa koivua. Okay. Looks okay. And I lubricate those. Yes and no. You can see here and other is underneath here. It's stuck. Put this back on. Stunt boiler is okay. Maybe I drop this a little bit. No disc. Damn, it's fast. This is nice. My other CD player have skip to next track, but not like that. You can scroll this back and forward. This is absolutely yes. It's not working. This is something, but maybe it's near to this cover. Maybe there is some kind of sensor. Okay, let's try again. Welcome. I need to check this switch. Yes. Let's see a switch. Over there. Cleaner. Welcome to DVD world. Okay. But now it's still closed without help. It's like a stock somehow. When it's open. Ooh. Maybe just need a little bit more lubricate. Let's connect this machine. Maybe you can remember my amplifier. Working nice. It's stuck here. Take a look. Take a look this when I put eject. Oy. What? Doesn't look nice. I need to open. Let's open. Power off and I lubricate the spot. Always you swap. Gears out there. Here is. I don't have this silicone-based lubricant, but this oil is almost good. Really good. The camera here. maybe a little bit smoother. Doesn't fix this. This remote control. It's giant. This is my Sony. And here is extra buttons. I have Panasonic Super VHS recorder player. And I believe there was something like that, but when I bought it, my machine, there was no remote control. But it was something like that, and even double-sided. Let's see, power, okay. TV, okay. There's TV over here. And power, display title, menu marker, return, subtitle, audio, angle, skip, charge, stop, still, pause, play, and I don't know what that means. Track number, probably, if I want to play. Number 5. Yes, it's working. I can play it. But it's working. Eject. It's still track here. I don't know if this take here or what, but always need to be something wrong. I believe this video. It's now complete and finished, and I have last month video, very long video. It's a very old computer, Pentium 4 Celeron processor, 250K of RAM, 40 gig of hard drive, something like that, and I upgrade, of course, that machine, but it's very long video and many parts, because I record that with my pocket camera, only 2 gig of RAM of that. And many parts, and I need to add those parts together and edit. This is a very long time, and when I was sick I can't do it. So patience, I will do it. Bye bye.